I can't even do it.
Welcome to episode 22 of Chaz Wins. I'm your host, Chaz Burke, and today we have a very special guest. This is Stacey Allen. She is a playwright, director, and she specializes in murder mystery, known to us as the Queen of Murder Mystery.
That's stupid.
That's a pretty accurate description.
If you say so, okay.
I think that's an accurate description. But yeah, we're welcome, and it's wonderful to finally sit down again and talk with you and get you on camera, and I think you have some interesting things that I'm sure people want to hear about, because I certainly do. You're busy. So first of all, tell us about how you got started.
Trying to stay busy. First of all, let me give you a gift up right there. This was totally unplanned.
It was.
We just come from outside chilling in the park.
Right. Rehearsing,
so,
actually.
Yeah, so. Rehearsing. So we didn't know he was going to do this, but we'll get it done. But I did bring you a gift. It is the Jazz Bean Fan.
See, I love when guests bring gifts. So.
Yeah, those hot summer days.
It's a church fan.
It happened to be in my purse.
It's actually perfect, actually, because it's hot down here. Yeah. You know, when there's too many of us in the room, we get... Mm-hmm. Even though we bright-skinned it, we still get hot.
Yeah.
But thank you. Look at that.
You like it?
Yes, I do. Absolutely. Okay. Thoughtful of you. Yeah. And like you said, we were just rehearsing, so today is one of those hot summer days, and we're out to figure we'll kill two birds with one stone and get you on tape and talk about the upcoming things that Jazz Bean Events is working on.
Okay, so we do have a murder mystery show coming up in October. I know it's in October, I just can't give you the exact date yet because I didn't confirm the date.
We'll get it on.
So we do have a murder mystery show coming up in October. If you've never been to a murder mystery show, it's a murder mystery dinner show. We're going to call this one our soul food murder mystery dinner show. We're going to have great food. We're going to have it catered.
Soul food mystery.
Soul food murder mystery.
Food ain't a mystery.
The food's not the mystery.
Okay.
It's going to be the soul food. But the mystery will be everybody trying to figure out who done it. It's a whodunit. It's for these food. If you're a whodunit lover, you're going to love the soul food murder mystery show. So you attend the show and you're going to watch Detective Table try to solve crime. And Detective Table is always, always a suspect in his own investigations.
So he has a little history, though. He has a little background, little sketchy background.
He's that shady, crackling bone Detective Table. Like I said, he's always a suspect in his own investigations.
Now, this is your second production of with the Detective Table series?
With the Detective Table. There is, the first one was Who Killed Lenny Trombone?
Yeah.
But the up-and-coming one in October is Who Made the Beef Stew? So, like, you'll... come, like I said, the date hasn't been confirmed yet, but we're confirming the date now. And when I get that done, you'll get more information.
And we'll definitely
go. We'll definitely
put it out. I wanted to give the folks the opportunity just to see the face behind the name Stacey Allen and what goes on, because we share information online as we do here at Chaz Wins. We like to put people out in front of the spotlight so people can know and find out. So, what's some of your social medias that people could reach you? What's your main contact?
Well, everything is powered by Jazz Bean Entertainment. That's on Facebook. That's how I got to start, Jazz Bean Entertainment. One of the great things I will say about the difference between Jazz Bean Entertainment, where I just hired a lot of the local bands, entertain people, come out and provide entertainment, have a good time. The Soul Food Murder Mystery is a lot different because Not many people know that it was written and directed by me. So it's not just Jazz Bean Entertainment hiring a local band to entertain you. It is actually my work of art that you'll be hopefully entertained by.
I'm sure people will, because it is just, it is, that's that. It's art. You take your stories and you create a scenario in your mind and put it on a screen or on a stage, and you know, by no means, that's not an easy task to do. It really isn't.
It is so rewarding to see your own work play about, you know, and the actors and actresses that I have working with me are
good,
so great.
A good group of folks that are dedicated.
Good group of people, and just to see them come out and do their thing, watch them from start to finish, rehearse their lines. He's in. He plays Nico in Who Made the Beef Soup.
And that was my first real production. Sit down and actually be behind the screen, you know, be on screen. So looking forward to doing that again. And this time with more practice and more skill, more time rehearsing, getting ready. So I'm looking forward to it. It's another challenge. So
he was great for his first time. You did a really good job for the
I had fun.
And not only did you do it, you didn't have time to rehearse. You were like the last person in to come in. You filling in for someone. He stepped up to the plate, said, I'll do it. And you did great for somebody coming in and learning your lines for the very first time.
I learned a lot. It was a cool experience. Mm-hmm. And it really was fun.
A mini show that we did for some people, just to let people know and try to get them familiar with the audience. Mm-hmm.
No one else is doing it here in the city, in Pittsburgh. Yeah. No, so this is unique. No one else that I know of that is doing it.
It's something different. It's not like just, you know, going to sit down. I love listening to jazz. I love listening to a live R&B band. I love that. But this is just something different. You know, you don't have to always go to a party or plan an event with a band or a DJ. We entertain. The Soul Food Murder Mystery Show is there to entertain. Event, we will show up and we will be your entertainment. You know, anniversaries, birthdays.
Yep. And it's a great, it's something different.
Yeah,
it's different because people are interactive, your crowd stays interactive, and you know, it's for grown folks. Mm-hmm. You can sit back, relax, it's sophisticated.
And you get to win a prize at the end, and everybody have fun. If you love games, if you remember the game Clue or any type of whodunit, it's just fun. It's just a really good thing to do. And like I said, it's my baby only because I wrote it and directed the show from start to finish. So
It's always entertaining. It's always well read when you go through the script. And I'm amazed, in all sincerity. I'm amazed at how you're able to put all this stuff together. And it takes talent. So,
Talent for my actors, too. Like the actors that's in the play. Mm-hmm. That's a lot of work to learn your lines.
It is, but you have some really good professionals. So, mm-hmm.
And some of them are actually just first time, like yourself. Yeah. There's more than just one first time actor in here. So everybody's like doing a really great job. Yeah.
So like I said, I want to just get you in here for a little bit. I know you got a busy schedule, but I wanted people to be able to follow you, and you can do that. Follow Jazz Bean on Instagram.
Fan yourself.
Well, they can't see the Jazz Bean. And on Facebook, you have to follow Jazz Bean, Stacey Allen, as well. So just add her to your list, and you'll be able to find her work on there, on YouTube channel as well. What's your YouTube channel?
It's actually, Jazz Bean on Facebook. You can follow the business page on Facebook, which is Jazz Bean Events Pittsburgh. That's the Facebook. And then on YouTube, it's just Jazz Bean Entertainment.
So we're going to put the link right here. It'll be scrolling across the screen. You folks can check that out right there. That's how you can find her.
Yeah, please follow to stay informed. Or they can email murdermysteryshow@yahoo.com.
murdermysteryshow@yahoo.com.
And I will put
them. You still use Yahoo?
Yeah.
Wow.
What's wrong with Yahoo?
Nothing.
Murder.
You didn't say AOL, so at least you didn't say AOL.
murdermysteryshow@yahoo.com. If you email that email, did I say it right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
You send me an email, you'll get updates and stay informed when the next show is about to take place.
There you go.
Yes.
You
go. I'm going to be an actor.
And you're looking for always open talent call if you're
always
interested.
Always looking for open talent. Yes.
Good.
Or if you just want information on the show yourself, just email, and I'll send it out to you. And if I have enough, you may even
get... absolutely.
You may, if you give me your address, then you may even get a Jaspie fan. See?
Handmade.
Handmade.
Handcrafted.
Hand,
I'm sorry.
Yeah. There's plenty of uses for that Jaspie fan.
Yep. I like it, though. Like I'm in church, taking me back.
Yeah.
Let me quit.
You can do a lot. You can stir your coffee.
Yeah, well, you could.
You can stir your coffee if you wanted to. So.
Well, thank you. Thanks for stopping by the studio here. We always appreciate our folks to stop and taking time to, you know, just check up on us and bless us with your presence here. And I'm going to, again, urge everyone to please follow Stacy Allen and Jazz Bean Productions.
Yeah, that's what I'm going to do.
That's a wrap.
This is the curtain down moment.
Okay.
So you want to leave the audience.
I can't even do it.
This is Dan the Man on sports. Tonight we have a special report on the NBA Finals and a most wonderful game as Cameron Johnson absolutely posterizes PJ Tucker tonight and a whirlwind dunk that broke the internet. Here we have a picture of latest sponsor Lipton Tea, because he got teabagged like a mug. Mm-hmm. And moving on to MMA fighting, Conor McGregor lost last night as he got balled up in a fight where his leg was broken severely. And here he is with his new sponsor, Twizzlers. I know that was a low blow, but he got messed up. But he vows to fight again, and rumor has it that he will be fighting next on the docket, Mike Tyson.
All right, it's your friendly neighborhood Batman again. What's happening, people? Listen, I've got a message. This message goes out to all the people I think deserve a little pat on the back, because they're always taking a lot of grief. They're always taking a lot of grief. And they don't get enough acknowledgement. So today, Batman wants to send a special bat shout out to all the baby daddies out there. That's right. Now, hold on. I know some of your baby's mamas is upset right now. But listen, it ain't always about you all the time. Without your baby daddy, you wouldn't have your baby. You know what I'm saying? And listen, hey, get back in focus here. Let me calm down. Okay, so listen. You know, seems like the world forgets about all the hard work that baby daddies put in, earning a paycheck, spending their time teaching their young sons how to grow up and be young pimps. I mean, how to grow up and be strong, responsible young men. That's right. It ain't easy. Listen, I know what it's like. I raised Robin. I was a single parent. And, you know, people still don't give me enough credit for raising Robin. And he turned out to be okay. I ain't seen him in a couple of years, but that's besides the point. Point is, fellas, keep holding it down. Do what you do, and don't worry about, you know, what your baby mama got going on, because they stay hating no matter what. You know what I'm saying? And don't get yourself a new pair of shoes, because that's a whole different ballgame. You really ain't allowed to have nothing. They ain't happy to you walking around the city broke holes in your pants, shoes all busted up, and you're driving a hoopty. You know? So go out and do your thing. Get you some 20s, 22s. Put you some Dayton's on your whip. And just go on out and enjoy yourself, fellas. Okay? Straight from Batman. Alright, peace out. Stay safe out in them streets.
You just never know who's coming to the Chaz Wind Show on Grind City TV. You don't know. You never know. Batman, sometimes we got the Angry Weatherman, sometimes Kung Fu Mike will pop up every now and then. I mean, Reverend Johnson. We ain't seen Reverend Johnson or Sister Gladys in a while. Now, I wonder if they know the pandemic's over. I expect to see her pretty soon because, you know, Sister Gladys been sick and shut in for a while, so I know she's going to get out. Probably got a new weave and everything. And, you know, that's what I'm just saying. You got to keep checking back here with us because you just never know. And it keeps. I like to stay focused. And it's hard with all this craziness going on around here. So continue to come back and continue to support. I really want to thank today's guest, Mrs. Stacy Allen, for doing her thing and taking the time to visit us. And again, shout out to and happy anniversary, first year anniversary to Pandemic Press Publishing. 1 year old, you know, the Cubbage family doing their thing out there. And actually, we're going to have them on real soon, actually. We're going to get them on the schedule in the books, along with some other people. We got to get the CEO back on here, Ms. Kay Bay, coming for you. So make sure you're ready. We'll get you on here because, you know, I think you got to have to let the people know what you got going on because you've been busy behind the scenes, as always. So we want to get you out in front of the camera. So that's what we do. If you want to come on the Chaz Wind Show or at least send me some material or have a conversation, whatever, email me is the best way to get a hold of me. ChazWins38@gmail.com. ChazWins38@gmail.com. That's pretty much it for today's show. Today's show, episode 22, is in the books. And we're always looking for sponsors. You know, you might see this. You might be a company to want to get your product, your services out in front of the people. Chaz Wins is looking for sponsors. So we'd be happy to rock you, you know, support your brand. Because we can do that right here. Put you in front of lots of people. You know what I mean? So I appreciate y'all for always checking us out. We're always so humble. More foolishness. I want to thank our guest today, Stacy Allen. She is very dope. We love her. She's doing great, wonderful things with her plays, and I'm happy to be associated with her. Always a delight to be around. Just congratulations on your success, and we wish you much, much more. And on that note, I got to give a big, big, big shout out to my fam, the Cubbage family, Samuel and Bobby Cubbage, who are the owners of the Pandemic Press Publishing. They are so dope. They have been working so hard, and they're such great supporters of everything we do here on Chaz Wins. A happy first year anniversary to you guys. Congratulations, because that is no small feat to be able to continue to keep going during this pandemic, to start something in the middle of a pandemic. And they've got so much going on with the radio show. Check them out, please. Pandemic Press Publishing. And they are just on top of things, you guys. They are very creative, very sincere, and like I said, they're just good folks that are just putting their stamp on this world. Like I always tell everybody, you know, this is the gold rush. You got to go out here and make it happen right now, whatever it is that you do, whether you're somebody like the Cubbage family, whether you're somebody like Stacy Allen, whether you're somebody like Kay Bay with her productions and her Grind City Network. There are just things going on in our community, and I like to spotlight that because it just shows you that life can be something different. It can be what you make it. You just got to have the desire to do it, and you got to have the dream in your mind to envision it, and just go out and make it happen. Who cares how it comes out? Just do it, whatever that is for you. I know we all got different talents and different levels of stuff and different levels of commitment, but I'm telling you, when you get out there and you start doing your thing, don't worry about what everybody else is doing or what they think. Have fun with your life. Life is too short. So get on out there. Like I said, I make fun of myself first. That's what I do. That's my cup of tea. It's more like a cup of coffee because y'all know I like my Arabica bean coffee. Yes, I've had 3 cups already. And I'm about to get another one. But that's just life for me. You know, a good cup of coffee just gets my soul right. You know, and that I can come on screen and act a fool.
And like I said, you all are to blame because you keep on encouraging me, and I love that. So, like I said, we are going to continue this journey. It has been so dope. It's rewarding every time I get to turn on the TV and see one of my friends, or turn on the internet or see one of my friends doing something, excelling at what they love to do. And I just can't say enough about it. And as always, I feel so blessed to have this opportunity right here on Grind City TV Network Roku. This is the place to be, y'all. We got entertainment out the wazoo. Whatever wazoo is. I'm just saying. Technically, I don't know. But we got it, and it's coming out of it. All right, y'all, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll get back to some more foolishness, because that's what we're good at right here on Chaz Wins on Grind City TV Network Roku. P.J. Morton's.
According to Wikipedia, P.J. Morton is an American Grammy winner.
No. Cam Johnson.
According to Wikipedia, Cameron Jordan Johnson is an American professional basketball player for the Phoenix Suns of the National Basketball Association.
P.J. Tucker. That's all fucked up. Y'all think this is a game? This ain't no game. Yes, it is.
Can you look this way? To make sure the glare isn't too bad.
Got a glare?
No, you're good. Rolling.
Oh, hello. This is Sister Gladys coming to you with a very special Mother's Day greetings to all you mothers out there. Now, some of you men's is mothers too. I'm just, it's a different kind of mother, but I don't mean that's ain't your day. Father's Day did it come already? No, it's coming. So, let's shout out to all the mothers out there who just love the little children's. And I just want you all to enjoy your day, enjoy your dinner at the fine, fancy restaurants that your family's gonna take you to. You know, me, Sister Gladys, I like to go to, what's that buffet, King Country Buffet, or that Golden Corral? That's. Sister Gladys loves to go there. Them honey buttermint biscuits, what is so sweet and delicious? Mm-mm-mm. You know, Reverend Johnson took me there one time. Just one time. We ain't never been back. Because I ate up all the biscuits. But anyway, I just want to say, if you want to get your somebody special, your special mother, sister, grandmother, or something, get them one of them pyramids, one of those transmutations, one of those things, queen of somebody. They make nice gifts. They make nice gifts, they do. So yeah, go and get you one of them. And just happy Mother's Day. And everybody, enjoy yourselves. All right, Sister Glass got to go now. I got to soak my bunions.
Today's show, episode 22, is in the books. And we're always looking for sponsors. You know, you might see this. You might be a company to want to get your product, your services out in front of the people. Chaz Wins is looking for sponsors. So we'd be happy to rock you, you know, support your brand. Because we can do that right here, put you in front of lots of people, you know what I mean? So I appreciate y'all for always checking us out. We're always so humble. Stay safe this week, enjoy yourself, and make the most of life. And most importantly, stay dope. We'll catch you next time. You still rolling?